Next, we talk about momentum. Okay, so how the authors define momentum was by the 12-month returns, okay, excluding the latest month. All right, why excluding the latest month is because researchers found that there tend to be some reversal on a month-by-month basis, so you don't want the momentum to be affected when there's some correction in the latest month. So they excluded the latest month. They only measure the last 12 months excluding the latest month. Okay, so that's how they define a stock with momentum. Okay, so basically very price based. They want to buy stocks that went up and short the stocks when they go down. Okay, so their top 30% and bottom 30% by their 12-month returns. The top 30% will be the up momentum stock, and the bottom 30% will be the down momentum stocks. Okay, so you want to compare the difference. So if you long both portfolio, right? Okay, that's what happened. So if you long the up momentum stocks and you long the down momentum stock in the same period, each year the up momentum stock portfolio will give you 9.6% per year. Okay, so this is a bit counterintuitive from the value stocks that we talk about, because value usually you buy low and sell high, right? Whereas momentum, you are buying the highest price stock for that year, okay? And that generated an outsized 9.6% per year returns, okay? So momentum, if you really discovered throughout the book, right, it gives you the highest performance gap compared to the other factors that we talked about today. But momentum is not a free lunch again. I learned a lot more about momentum from this book as compared to value and size. Okay, so two types that I learned about momentum is that the first type is called a cross-sectional momentum, which means you are actually comparing to the same asset class, right? Other kind of stocks that is being ranked in that space, and you identify the top 30% and bottom 30%, which we have just done. So okay, so the slide that we see just now, this slide, all right, is known as the cross-sectional trend momentum factor. Okay, there's a comparison, there's a relative ranking, whereas for time series momentum, it is absolute. So for example, you just need to compare this stock A, for example, the price now and the price 12 months ago, I know whether this is up or down. Okay, if it's up, I long, if it's down, I short. Alright, so that is more absolute. I don't need to know whether stock B, how stock B is doing, stock C is doing. So it's just by itself, I can tell what's the trend. So most of the traders that you heard of, or the trading strategy called trend following, is usually a time series based momentum. Okay, so either way it works. Alright, so but they just want to explain it in more detail about this momentum. And as I said, this is the best performing factor, but you also have large losses. So for example, in the last 2008 financial crisis, momentum had almost half of the returns being wiped out, half of the portfolio being wiped out. Okay, so these are issues, all right, when the market turns, especially in the 2009 financial crisis, 2008 financial crisis, and 2009 was a rebound, right? It was a very fierce rebound, if you remember. So momentum had very big issue when it comes to rebounding. Okay, actually, it wasn't on the crash part. It was on the rebound part that momentum lost a lot of money in the last crisis. Okay, so one of the mitigating measures that you can use to dampen the losses was to use multiple factors, right? So instead of just putting everything in momentum, even though it's like the best performing factor, there's a lot of risk that's involved, and you do not want to get caught. And that's why putting some money in value, putting some money in size, will make you better. Okay, so that's one way. There are also other ways that are being mentioned in the book, which if you want to know more, you can always read it. And lastly, about momentum, was that Farmer and French, right, the guys who found value and size, have never want to acknowledge momentum as a real factor, because what they found is that momentum worked in every country except one, and that's Japan. All right, and AQR, which is a famous factor-based investing hedge fund based in US, and they explain, not that momentum didn't work in Japan, it was suppressed because the value was a lot more overpowering. So if you use a value investing in Japan for the last 10-20 years, you should be doing very, very well. Okay, and why, if value is overpowering, your momentum loses this excess return was because momentum and value factors tend to be negatively correlated. So one do well, the other one tends not to do well. So if value has been doing very well in Japan, that would suppress the performance of momentum. So what they are trying to argue is that it's not that momentum don't work, it's that value in Japan was a lot stronger than anywhere else in the world.